Joining us on the line is Congresswoman Maria Elvira Salazar. She is a 5-time Emmy Award-winning journalist, and she just won a massive upset election in South Florida. Representative Salazar, thanks so much for joining the program. Really appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you very much for having me, Ben.
So why don't we talk about how you won your district? Obviously, that was a major upset, and in a very closely divided House, it makes a huge difference. So how did you pull out that victory?
Well, I think that's basically because of socialism. My district is district number 27 in South Florida, the home of the exile community, because it includes the city of Miami. But it also has a lot of non-Cuban Hispanics, meaning Central Americans, Mexicans, Nicaraguans, Hondurans, Salvadorians. And they understand what the word socialism means. My opponent, Donna Shalala, who was the president of the Clinton Foundation at the time when Hillary Clinton was the Secretary of State. Not only she was also the longest serving member of the Clinton cabinet. She said at one point that she was a pragmatic socialist. And that was the key, because when you say socialist, I repeat, people run the other way in my district. Why? Because we have lifted.
So Congresswoman Salazar, one of the things that the left has suggested is, of course, that Latino voters, Hispanic voters will inevitably vote for Democrats. And indeed, in places like California, Hispanic voters and Latino voters tend to vote heavily Democrat. That's not true in Texas and Florida. What do you think the difference is?
Well, that's a very good question. You know, I think the difference is that in South Florida, the GOP, we have paid more attention to the Latino vote. Could be the brown vote, the Latino vote, the Hispanic vote, any way you want to call it, Ben. But one of the things that the GOP needs to do now is to talk to my audience, to talk to those voters. And I am the perfect example that between 20 and 25% of the non-Cuban Hispanic Democrats voted for Salazar, who was Cuban-American, and he was a Republican. And what does that tell you? That tells you that we have the same values that are entrenched in the Republican Party. God-fearing, law-abiding, tax-paying, family-oriented, and small government. We in the GOP, we have not paid enough attention to those voters who we happen to be the 20% of the population of the United States. We are the largest minority in the country. And the GOP needs to be talking to us more, welcoming us into the party and letting them know that we want them to vote for us. Something that we haven't done that much in California.
So Representative Salazar, obviously in Congress, the Democrats continue to ram through massive spending package after massive spending package. We saw late last week, the economic report from last month, that was wildly disappointing. What do you make of how the Biden administration approach to the economy is impacting small businesses and the economy?
Because unfortunately, Ben, the Democratic Party, a noble party at one point, has been infiltrated by the Democratic Socialists. And I repeat, socialism is misery, exile, and oppression. And unfortunately, the people that are peddling that that ideology do not understand what they're saying. But then Nancy Pelosi and leadership within the Democratic Party is terrorized for the progressive, or terrorized by AOC and Ilhan Omar. And they believe that those people are going to bring them the votes. And that's when we are at a crossroads. And I am terrified, and so is my community, regardless whether they're Democrats or independents or Republicans, is because we know that those policies don't take you anywhere. And even AOC said about what President Biden was proposing in this last joint sessions of Congress that I was there, that he's more progressive than she is. But what does progressive mean? Progressive means socialist. And what does socialism mean? Well, we've tried it. Listen, if big government were to be the solution, Venezuela should be Switzerland.